So, hello guys, it's Naim Prodhan from peak 945 here from Dhaka. So, today we will explain on some topic of the current pandemic related issues. So, the concern is like I read somewhere that there is a debate going on when the reopening our economy or turn off the lock. So here I have some reasons and logic to explain you that when it's gonna get reopened. Okay, so some of the reasons that I found from Ian Breamer's email that few of the things is causing this delay of the reopening. Because I tell you one thing, there's a word called, term called trade-off. Like if you give some, if you lose something here, you get something there. And if you don't get something here, you get something there, right? So it means this is the trade-off. So the term two thing is that, related is the public health versus the economic health. So you want to kill your people and grow your economy, or you want that we keep at home till the vaccine is prepared, right? So which governor or the government or the country head will let their people come out to the road and get infected and come back and let the whole family die, right? It's not a good idea, right? So this is the thing. The trade-off is going on there, and it's not a flipping a coin or a switch like that. You will let the shutdown off, let people get out, and all of a sudden they get infected, get in, and kill their whole family. Right? It's not gonna happen because our government doesn't want that. So it's not gonna end the lockdown so soon until. At least in next 1 year, because till the vaccine is invented and the whole people of the world are vaccinated, till then we can't take risk of the people of our country, right? So it's just my opinion and the prediction that the entrepreneurs and their people made, okay? And I get that information from them through the email, and also I did some research over the internet. So it's actually telling that it's not gonna be open even so soon, okay? So next, one more thing is that there is a fight over privacy, okay? So, for example, you go in a traveling in a bus, so you're sitting beside your next person is infected with corona. So will you take your risk to get in with the corona? It's not a good idea, right? So, some business has some impact over this pandemic, like the hospitality, tourism, restaurant, and cinema halls like entertainment. They're not gonna go to the cinema hall and sit side by side and get infected, right? And you consider the scenario of the big stadium full of audience or supporters of the team who are playing, that you sit here, after that there's a three-seat block, then you sit one more person, then three-seat block. So the concern is who's paying more to get that seat, because the seat size is smaller, right? So it's not going to happen so soon because there's a trade-off, right? So health is first, right? So to keep to get a better economic condition, you have to take some care of your health, right? So to get a better impact in your health, you have to stay at home, keep safe for some time till the vaccine is invented. So once you have a better health, you can have a better economic condition, right? So all the governors and governments of the world want that. So stay home, keep safe. This is my advice and is just a prediction, okay? Next is, who are getting benefited in this type of pandemic conditions? The businesses like the child e-commerce, Then the pharmaceutical companies were preparing the anti-infectious items or the other product health related. They're getting more benefited over the time of this 1 year at least. And which country is getting more benefited? That is India and China. But not so high, but the curve will be higher than the other countries, and then it will be flattened. So during this lock, people is suggested that you invest on yourself, you prepare skills, you invest in gold, properties, so that later on you can get better result, okay? And India, who has much money, is suggested that you start this type of e-commerce business, because what will happen during this lockdown? People are stuck at home, they're more involved with the internet related things, they are getting service of any sort, like buying groceries, taking online courses, communicating with people. Everything is going to be digital, right? So in online event, which business are getting more benefits? People who are selling everyday lifestyle items, the things that we need regularly, are getting more benefited, like groceries, coke, like beverages, restaurant items. You're ordering from home and they're coming to the doorstep, and they're getting more benefited. But in this type of restriction, people are not gonna buy the luxury items like televisions, furniture. Those things are not for this type of position. And other one thing I must tell you that during the it's a recession, not a depression, right? In 1930 there was a big great depression, right, which was started in the US. And then after that, overall, the whole world globally was affected by the economic down, okay? And we were 15% down over that time. And now, it is a recession which happened in 2009 to 2010 over the 1 year period. And this time, this is higher, 30 times higher, okay? Over the countries, okay? And every quarter of 2009, It was reducing, and after that, it was even reduced more. And so you must understand that at least 1 year it will take to get the vaccine. And some people are telling that vaccine is invented, blah, blah, blah. Those are not actually correct news, okay? And the thing is that our health is very important, right? And what else for today? That's it. So the summary is, it's not very quick reopen, okay? And public gathering will not happen so sooner. So the businesses which require people to come closer and work together will have less opportunity over this recession. But and like the manufacturing, then. Oh, like tourism, hospitality, manufacturing, this type of business will have a crash, right? And internet-based business, e-commerce giants, and pharmaceutical people will get more benefit, okay? This is my insight from Peak 945. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.